Hey guys, what is going on? It is Larknok 1 slash Shakespeare Addict here, and we are going to continue our journey in Civilization Beyond Earth. We are playing as the Pan-Asian Cooperative. We are going to go for a supremacy victory this game. And at the end of the last part, I finished exploring down south here. I didn't mention that we actually saw some more Firaxite. We've got two workers. You know, we're about to get done with our four initial food locations here. We've got the two farms and the two fruit. So that'll keep us afloat for a while, I suppose. And the goal now is to get two generators here and here. And under the solar collector, they're going to have just a lot of energy pouring out of those spots. Basically as plain rivers with generators, there's going to be a yield of one food, one production, and four energy. That is a massive yield, and hopefully we'll be able to get our energy up from what it is right now, which is 10 per turn. And the higher that gets, the better it's going to be for us to basically be able to afford colonists at 640 energy. That's the goal. We want to have as many colonists as we can up to about turn 110, 120. And that's where we are right now. So let's go ahead and clear this miasma here as we continue to explore up northwest. Now, the Slavic Feds did land over here, and Kavitha has not yet landed. So we're still waiting for that. Now, while we're busy, I suppose we can continue to explore by Kozlov. Alrighty. Okay, another resource pause. That's nice. And our worker here finished, so let's get him working on the second generator. Okay, so we have the Vivarium quest now. I typically always go with the food here. I love having a three food building. It really helps with growth. And discover resource pod. Yeah, we'll pick up that resource pod next turn. So we finished the recycler. We still have four turns until we finish pioneering, which is going to unlock the trade depot and the colonist. And the trade depot quests up to two production, so it's an incredibly good building to get down. But we want to have we have the opportunity to build one of these before we actually get to pioneering. So we can go with either the lab or the clinic right now. The ultrasonic fence is not the best choice, honestly. It's only really good for its quest, which allows your trade routes to not be hit by aliens. So really the choice here is between two health and one science, or three science. And three science per turn is particularly good, and you know, honestly, growing too quickly is not going to be a huge issue for us because of absolutely how slow the food production is. So let's go with the lab here. And let's see if we can actually speed up our growth a little bit, because 10 turns for the 6th citizen is a little slow. So we can actually speed it up quite a bit. 8 turns is a bit better. And let's keep on going. Alright, so 25 culture. That's not bad. It's going to get us our next virtue. And we're going to finish our 5k, at least part of the 5k 4m, with social mores here, giving us 10% culture in this city and bringing our culture return up to 8, which is incredibly high for this early in the game. All right, so we got another quest. Oh boy, I sure do love quests.
The temple doors of the Protectorate are open.
Looks like Kavitha landed. And, oh, sweet. All right, so we have a choice here between a science-heavy station, I suppose, and a science and production station. So I'm going to go with Jinsoku Labs. I really, really, really love stations that have a good even split between production and some other resource that I like, which is either science or culture, really. So we're going to go with Jinsoku Labs. So that's actually nice. They didn't settle in a part of the map that we wanted to settle ourselves in. And also, what's nice about this spot is you can trace a nice clean line for a trade route that doesn't go through miasma. So Jinsoku Labs is going to be a very viable asset when we go to basically when we go to build colonists after we get our trade depot up. So here we have the choice between plus one food from recyclers, which is, that could be a safe choice considering food is an issue for us. But the 10 plus 10% worker speed is just so good. Even though we already have the buff from the Pan-Asian Cooperative, I just can't turn this down. It's incredible. So we're going to go next turn and see where that brings us. All right, so some titanium there, some fungus, some xenomass. Looks like this is a bit of a harmony bias. So Kozlov could in fact be going harmony. And we didn't actually see where Kavitha landed. So she landed over here. We do have a bit of an ocean divide between us. So I'm not too terribly worried about her causing problems for us.
The universe is either in progress or in entropy. We choose progress.
All right, so we got pioneering now. So we might want to check if we want to swap from the lab over to the trade depot. So the trade depot comes in 5 turns, and the lab's going to finish in 3. So we're actually just going to let the lab finish. Because that science per turn is actually quite valuable. Let's get to work on our second generator. And in fact, I believe cutting down those trees will get us the trade depot a little quicker. So now we have the choice, now that we're done with pioneering, we're done with the core 3 techs, to pick up one of these surrounding techs. Now engineering is going to give us the thorium reactor, which is going to be especially a lot of energy per turn early. It quests up to 5 energy per turn, which makes it one of the best sources of energy in the early game, and in fact in the game, period. And physics over here is particularly good for supremacy builds in that it gives you this plus 1 science from Phyraxite, and plus 2 science. So it's a slightly more expensive version of the lab. Not quite, because you do have to work the Phyraxite tile to get that plus yield. The downside is that you need improved Phyraxite, so it's not actually going to be useful for us until we pick up robotics. So I'm thinking that we go engineering, we pick up robotics, and then we might go physics or computing, depending on what our energy needs are, or hell, we might go power systems down here, which is going to help us get to level 1 supremacy. So let's get engineering now, and we'll think on the thorium reactor when that comes to be available for us. Oh, wow. All right, so there's a siege worm right here. So that's a void sitting or ending the turn right next to him. That's never good. I want to get a vision of this area, really. Give us an idea of what's really between us and these two. Okay, more aliens. Siege room came closer. Oh, wow. All right, so we got more petroleum down here and another crashed satellite. So that's actually quite interesting. All right, so now we're done with the lab and we can go ahead and pick up the trade depot. This is really going to kickstart our production and going to help us out. So we just grew to 6. That's nice. And we have another 11 turns until we hit 7. All right, so that's actually crazy. There's another alien skeleton there and there's another resource pod. So we're going to try to grab the resource pod. Hopefully there's not a nest right here. That would be really bothersome. Oof, we're ending the turn on the resource pod. So let's just wait another turn. Cleared the forest. Yep, we finished the trade depot very, very early. All right, that was good synchronization on our part. So now we can actually go to the clinic, which is very, very good. Again, I don't really want to start building colonists until we hit size 7. And the clinic is going to give us more science. It's going to give us a good health base. Part of what's good about this is that we are getting a little bit of science, 1.1 there, from being healthy. So going too negative in the health isn't going to help us out. So in that way, in that regard, we can actually think of the clinic as providing 2 science per turn and not just 1.
Instruct the children not to dream of toys or sweets. Instruct them to dream of infrastructure.
All right, so that actually gave us 19 science per turn right there and got engineering a bit earlier. We're getting the clinic in 3 turns, and we could do the thorium reactor in 7. So really the question here is, do we want the thorium reactor 10 turns from now or in 3 turns from... or in 7 turns from now? So the difference is really about 9 energy per turn. Is it worth building early? It's 9 energy per turn for... Sorry, 9 energy total versus 7 science total. I'm going to go with the 7 science. Let's finish the clinic. All right, so now we have the option. We have a few options here. We can go power systems here. This is actually going to take me a while to explain. Going supremacy is a bit interesting because you do have to plan to pick up the neural lab eventually. It's supremacy's strong focus science building. It comes at affinity level 4, though, so a little bit of work is required to unlock it. So to get to 1, we go power systems. We could rely on some quest to bring us to 2. Maybe we go tactical robotics. You never know. The thing about robotics that makes it a particularly good tech is that the autoplane is a fantastic building. It quests up to 3 production per turn, which makes it 3 production, which makes it one of the best buildings in the game. The attack jet is one of the best defensive units in the game, especially because AI can't zerg your units. They can't just swarm your attack jets and have them die. I suppose they could do air sweeps, but the AI never does. Manufacturing is a pretty good improvement. I tend not to use it. And the Fraxet Mine is, again, going to enable us to get our observatories. I believe also the Neural Lab, yes. More to the point, robotics is just very, very a good tech. So we're going to go ahead and pick up robotics. Then after that, we might go with either physics, power systems, or computing, as we need. Computing is going to have the network, physics is going to have the observatory, and power systems is just going to be pretty much just affinity points. So the other thing we want to keep in mind is we might not want to pick up power systems until we have adaptive sciences, because we're going to get 20% more affinity points out of that tech. So I just like to think optimally here. Oh, actually, you know what the thing is we could do here? I didn't even consider this. So Jinsoku Labs is up here, and we're not trading with them right now, so we could build the trade convoy and get that out as fast as we can. That's actually going to give us more science in the clinic and more production, which helps build the rest of them. So let's actually do that. That seems like a very safe choice. Oh, especially with the forest there helping trader out get out faster. Alright, so I'm a little concerned that if I walk here, there's going to be a nest right there. But they haven't attacked me yet, so they can't be that close. Alright, sweet. So that's actually a crap ton of Firaxite. It's certainly a very, very good spot. Hopefully I don't get attacked. Maybe there's a nest there, I don't know. Alrighty then. I didn't get attacked, so we can actually get our expedition. I don't want to risk trying to get the alien skeleton. I think that's probably too close. They probably have a nest right here, considering that the siege worm was up there. So let's open fire. Ooh, the aliens are pushing on both sides. Well, you can never really tell if they're being too aggressive when they come this close to your city and your workers. I'm just going to assume aggression. I do eventually plan to kill all the aliens, because, I do plan on picking up survivalism and scavenging. In fact, I'm going to showcase our entry into might now with adaptive tactics. And survivalism and scavenging are going to lead us into might. We're going to get survivalism with our next virtue, and then scavenging is actually going to come free in that we're going to get the kicker here when we get survivalism. So let's go to the... Oh shit, I didn't move them. Fucked up. Okay. Praise Jesus. It's a matter of speech. Alright, so Jinsoku Lab is actually going to give us 3 production, because I believe the recycler gives extra production points for trade routes. So that is really going to up our production quite a bit. 15 to 18. It's wonderful. And in fact, Jinsoku Labs is going to level up over time and give more and more production, which is wonderful. This is actually quite good. I like our setup right now. So we finished our generator. That ups our energy per turn right from 10 to 13. That's nuts. And we got another one finishing in 2 turns. So we have a few options now. We could actually go try to build more farms over this way. Or we could try to expand this way. I'm not too comfortable expanding this way right now with the aliens around. So I'm going to go and try to build a farm over there. We pick up our clinic in one turn, and then we're going to get to work on the thorium reactor. So this is going to be our last building before we start building colonists. After that, after the thorium reactor, we're just going to be focusing purely on colonists. And yeah, that's about it. So I want to hit 7. That'll be it. Okay. So that didn't particularly change our energy per turn. The aliens are not being too accommodating right now. I suppose I need to be on production sources right now, because I really should get up a mine, so I really should buy this tile if we're not going to acquire it soon. I mean, I could hope that they acquire it in 6 turns, but knowing cities, they're just going to acquire one of these random tiles. Cities actually have very, very low priority for acquiring hills through culture. So what we might want to do is buy this. We'll move on to that tile next turn. And actually, yeah, I can go here. Boom. Yeah. So let's build a farm. Another one. And next turn, we'll move on to that hill and start building a mine. So alien retreated a little bit. Sorry, alien. I gotta do what I gotta do. We're building a mine there soon. So next turn, we hit 7, the critical size. And then once we're done with the thorium reactor, this looks rather nice, actually. We're going to have enough energy to buy colonists around the same time our first colonist finishes. Let's get to work on our first mine, sorry. How goes this expedition? 2 more turns. All right, hopefully it gives us a nice production boost. That way our first colonist will be particularly cheap. So we have our quest between +1 production from trade depots and +1 energy. I really, really love the production. I like to have high production cities, as high as I can, without having to pick engineers at the beginning of the game. So 19 production in our capital. We did get a production boost, so that's very good. We also got a science boost out of that because of the way that, you know, we virtued. So I'm going to leave this alien skeleton be. We don't actually have planetary survey, so we can't come quite down around and trying to pick up another expedition module. I honestly don't think it would work either, because I'm pretty sure the aliens are, in fact, there. It'd be highly aggressive to us coming that close. So let's just see what we can see, and we might bring that explorer eventually home. Alrighty, so we finished doing all that we had to. Now we can actually begin on the colonists. I'm making 21 energy per turn. That is absolutely nutty. So we can make 23 production and get a colonist out every 6 turns. This is incredible. This is what I was aiming for optimally. I'm glad we pretty much got it, even though we have a very bad start. Get another farm. Aliens are being troublesome. What else is new, honestly, with aliens? Okay, so what we could do now is we could actually do something that I like to do when I have a spare worker and nothing for him really to do that's quite safe for him to do. And that's micro our roads, which means I want to start road production, but not finish it anywhere. Because we're the Pan-Asian Cooperative, we're mega, mega efficient at producing things. We're actually getting our roads done in 2 turns rather than the usual, I think it's 3 or 4. So the way that this is going to work is we only have to start building a road on each tile once. So we're going to go back here and start next turn. We're going to be building it outwards this way, and we won't actually finish any of the tiles because we want to preserve our energy per turn. We're just going to put 1 turn into each tile. Even more petroleum. So strange. It's like the game is telling me that I should build a petroleum city. Sorry, a petroleum empire. Oh wow, that's slightly aggressive. Slightly aggressive behavior. So let's begin the first road. And get some vision. That is a lot of peroxide, though. We're definitely going to want to have to occupy that later. Alright, so now that we have 1 more turn on this road, we basically just push out. And we begin microing the next one. So they finished the mine here. Let's actually finish this chitin. This is going to give us a little more production. Because it is a fantastic tile. It tends to be a bit of a mixed tile. So here it's going to be 2 food, 2 production, 1 energy. That's quite good. If aliens don't eat me. Which I hope they don't. Come on. Don't eat me. Alright, so we put another tile here. We just keep moving. It's quite a simple process. Alright, more Phyraxite. Yeah, Krabrost grew very, very quickly. Citadella is growing proportionally. So we are only 2 turns away from our colonist and 2 turns away from being able to buy one. I kind of called it. Strategy is quite good. Alright, so we got a quest. That looks like it's either Solid State Citizen or the other one. Oh, it's Solid State. Alright. So Solid State Citizen is not too bad for us. The only downside is I have to get an explorer out there. I honestly don't see this one happening. So let's get a little more vision and we'll disband this explorer next turn for the energy. And then we'll build one as soon as this is done. So one more turn. The worst thing that could happen is that maybe a Kavithan, somebody's scout could come in and steal this. That would be horrible. Oops, it didn't micro. Alright, so I finished a road accidentally. It's going to drag our energy turn down by one. And where do we want this guy to be? Oh, that was probably... Oh, wait, no, this guy can only move one tile. We're safe. Okay, so we want to get an explorer out. And only one turn, wow. Alright, then we'll disband this guy. Bring our energy per turn back up to 21. And we want to keep building this road pretty much just this way. I want to put my first city... Where do I actually want to put my first city? That's an important thing. So the oil here is going to be very good as a production source. This is not terrible as a food production source. The basalt, this is a 2 production, 1 food tile. Not horrible, not too good. The fruit's going to be especially good. Oh, this is actually plains. It's not desert. All right, so this is still going to be a decent food source. So I'm thinking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's not a horrible spot for an expansion. It'll have access to one of these petroleums. Build another city over here. So what we might want to do is begin branching, starting with this tile going that way. And we'll plant our first city there. Head up this way. Okay. Shoot this alien because he's clearly threatening me. In some small part, and we can actually get to work on... I didn't optimally do this. Oh well. We can buy ourselves a colonist, and we'll move him next turn. These guys are kind of being bothersome. Manticores. Alright, so the thing is, we want to start Solid State Citizen as soon as we can. There's no real punishment in starting it a bit later. Acceptus Harmony. There's a punishment if you start it a little too early. Because you actually have to destroy your target station. So that's a bit troublesome. So that is actually the time mark. So, thank you guys for watching. This has been the second part of my Let's Play Beyond Earth. Let's play, I suppose. I'm bad with words, I'm sorry. But thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you guys next time.